Tonight, something new is being tried in Norman to fight high arsenic levels in the water. The city has had to make some expensive fixes since 2006 when the EPA dropped acceptable levels from 50 parts per billion to 10. The change caused nearly half of Norman's wells to be shut down. Now there's a new device that might be a solution. Eyewitness News 5's Amanda Guerra is live in Norman with the details of this experiment. Amanda?
Well, Maggie, inside this brick building behind me is one of those wells that was shut down in 2006. And since then, Norman officials have been looking everywhere for an answer to fix their arsenic problem. Well, now they think they might have found the solution.
These are gladiola bulbs. And these are lilies.
Fred Fenton gets pretty thirsty for water while getting his hands dirty in his garden.
I probably consume about close to half a gallon a day.
But when Fred heads to the sink, there's one thing he doesn't want in his water, arsenic.
Anything above the safe level really concerns me. And when it gets dangerously high, like five times the amount that it's supposed to be, it's a serious problem.
Well, the city of Norman has 13 water wells that are high in arsenic.
This is one of those 13 wells. Just like the other Norman water wells too high in arsenic, the city had to shut it down. But now, Norman water officials think this three-tank filter can fix their arsenic problems.
Water's going to flow into the top of the vessels. It's going to flow through the vessel. The arsenic will remain behind. And then the water minus the arsenic will come out the bottom. We'll treat it to disinfect it, and then we'll send it to our customers.
The city will test the $400,000 filter for 1 year. If successful, the city will put one in every water well too high in arsenic.
That's the idea, is that we can salvage wells that we can't use now.
It's something Fred says is worth every penny.
Well, I think that's a great idea, if there's a cost associated with just that filter, I wouldn't mind paying a little extra to get it done.
Okay, now good news for Fred. City officials say adding these filters will not raise any water bills here in Norman. In fact, they say so far building new wells has been their only solution to this problem. And they say adding one of these filters, that's actually $300,000 less than building a new well. We're live in Norman. Amanda Guerra, Eyewitness News 5.
Amanda, thank you. And this is the first time this filter has been tried in Oklahoma. So water officials in other parts of the state who are having similar problems are hoping it has positive results so it can be used in more places.